Hello, welcome to any TVN channel. You own a website and you want to keep it online. You want it to have a backup. When the main server fails, the backup server will replace it immediately. In this video, I will explain how to build a website with two servers. A primary web server and a backup web server. If anything happens to the primary server, the second server will be replaced. Data is always synchronized between two servers. Specifically in this video, the main server has an IP address of 10.11.32.180 and the secondary server has an IP address of 10.11.32.190. In addition, we will create a virtual IP address for the two servers, that is 10.11.32.222. This IP address represents both servers. When any server is online, it will use this IP. Normally, main server will use this IP address. If main server fails, then this IP address will belong to secondary server. So the website will use the virtual IP address 10.11.32.222. Let's start. In this video, I will use WordPress to create my own website. To be able to get website with WordPress, I need to install Apache, PHP and MariaDB. So I will install Apache, PHP and MariaDB for both servers. Next, we configure the database for this site. You open the database configuration file and update the IP address corresponding to each server. As in this example, the main server's IP address is 10.11.32.180. And the IP address of the secondary server is 10.11.32.190. Data is added, edited, deleted on the main server. The secondary server will back up all the same data on the main server. Next, to define the database for the main server, I assign the IP as 100. And assign the identifier to the secondary server as 101. Note that the identifiers need to be different on each server, the same will cause an error. On the main server, you create a username as web user and grant replication permission to the database on the main server. We will use this username to sync the database between the two servers. This is the command to view the main database status. With this command, you will get two parameters to allow the secondary server to connect to the primary server's database. I will write down this information to allow the secondary server to sync the database with the main server in the next step. On the secondary server, we synchronize the database with the main server. Here you use the information in the previous step to synchronize the database. The information includes the IP address of the main server, the username, the password, and two parameters of the main database. Don't forget to enable slave mode for the database on the secondary server. When viewing the status, if you receive the above message, it is successful. On the main server, I create a database for my website and name it WPDB. After creating a database on the primary server, a new database named WPDB also appears on the secondary server. Thus, the databases on the two servers have been synchronized with each other. Any changes on the main server will be synchronized on the secondary server. But for the second server, I want to allow only read database and not add, update, delete data. So on the secondary server I create a WP user username that has only read permission to the database. At this point we are done with configuring the database for the website as well as synchronizing the database between the two servers. Next step I will explain how to create virtual IP address for two servers. To generate virtual IP address for two servers I use KeepAlive. You install KeepAlive on both servers. Next open the systconfig file and add a line like I'm doing. Next you create a config file for KeepAlive on both servers and configure it like I'm configuring. First you update your virtual IP address. As in this example virtual IP address is 10.11.32.222. First you update your virtual IP address. The priority of the main server is 100 and the secondary server is 99. With this configuration, the virtual IP address is always prioritized for the main server. When the primary server crashes, a virtual IP address will be given to the secondary server. Also, you need to configure the password between the two servers so that they can connect with each other. Here, the password is set as 123456. The virtual IP address has been configured, the next step is to sync the WordPress site storage directory. You open the hosts file and add two lines as above. Each line includes IP address and mnemonic name. You can copy from main server to secondary server. To sync two WordPress folders I use Glosterfs. You install Glosterfs for both servers. In this video I use Ubuntu OS for both servers. And here are the commands to install Glosterfs on Ubuntu. After installation, you enable and start Glosterfs on both servers. After installation you enable and start Glosterfs on both servers. After the installation, we will configure WordPress sync using Glosterfs. First you connect the two servers with Glosterfs. You can see the status after connecting to check if it was successful. After After successful connection, create a shared folder on both servers called cluster storage. As you can see, when creating on the main server, the secondary server will also have a similar folder. Don't forget to start the newly created folder. Next, I will mount the newly created cluster folder with the website hosting folder on the main server. I use Apache's default directory to host my website. If you use another folder, customize it to your liking. But this is probably the simplest way. To avoid the error that when restarting the server, the mount will be lost, you need to edit the FS tab file and add the mount line as above. You do this on both servers. On the second server, I also use the default directory to sync my site directory. You need to edit the information accordingly for each of your servers. Otherwise, the mount will fail and the data will not be synchronized. Now I just need to install WordPress on the main server, the data will be synchronized with the secondary server. On the main server, I download the latest WordPress. As you can see on the second server, the WordPress file is also present. You unzip the downloaded file. After extracting, you copy the obtained files to the current directory. You will notice on both servers that the data is synchronized with each other. Then don't forget to give permission to the folder containing WordPress with both servers. To allow the website to be accessible from anywhere, you need a domain name and open port on your router. You can refer to how to open the port on the router on my NetVN channel. For this example, I pre-configured port forwarding on my router. The ports that need to be forwarded are 80 and 443. The IP address is the virtual address of the two servers. And this is also why we need virtual IP address, because it is not possible to open port for two IPs at the same time. In addition, I also created a free domain name for this website. I also updated the public IP address for this domain. If you want to know how to install DuckDNS on Ubuntu, you can review the videos on my channel or follow the instructions on DuckDNS homepage. With the update of the public IP address for the domain name as well as port forwarding on the router, you can access your website anywhere. You open a web browser and enter your domain name. The familiar WordPress configuration page has appeared. You find information about the database on the main server in the previous step to configure WordPress. Database name is WPDB, username is WPUser, password is password. On the next configuration page, you create a title, an admin account, and enter your email address to complete the installation. Next, I will create a simple post to test the sync between two servers. As you can see, the main server is using virtual IP address. To test the site redundancy, I will shut down the main web server. The virtual IP address has appeared on the secondary server. As you can see, the website is still working normally and the posts are synced even though the main server is down now. We will make the final configuration for the website, which is to encrypt the communication between the server and the user. In other words, configure HTTPS. I will power on the main server and install Let's Encrypt. As you can see, the virtual IP address has been reassigned to the main server. After installing Let's Encrypt, you configure with your domain name. Just like my previous videos, you enter your email address, then enter your selections like I am doing. You select the SSL configuration file and enable the HTTPS redirect for your site. Back to the website, next to the address bar appeared a lock icon. To configure Let's Encrypt on the secondary server, you need to turn off the main server. Because if the main server is running, the secondary server will give an error because the two servers are using the same domain name. So I finished building a website with two servers. One main server and one backup server. When the main server crashes, the secondary server will be replaced and your website will still work normally. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to netvn channel.